A sustainable stocking model is really fundamental to managing a business, particularly where you're retaining a core genetic asset in your herd. You need to protect that herd year in, year out. We've looked at our sustainable stocking model from the perspective of we have significant seasonal variability. How can we have our cattle interacting with that landscape in a way that there's resilience and buffer in that system to get us through the peaks and troughs in those seasons? Taking a scientific approach, a data-based approach to assessing the capacity of the landscape and understanding what that long-term carrying capacity is, and then building our stocking models and our breeding programs and all of those programs around that sustainable stocking model out into the future. Sustainable stocking strategy goes hand in hand with the work that we've been doing around our annual forage budgeting process, building technologies that help us to measure the available pasture in the landscape and using that to then match that feed supply with the feed demand, and using that to plan out our stock movements. We've been able to take a lot of operational cost out of the business as a result of having a much stronger forward-looking plan around what that feed resource base is. It's also enabled us to give our landscape the best opportunity, particularly coming out of, you know, drought or a run of drier seasons, the best opportunity to respond to rainfall when it comes and to really be resilient to those peaks and troughs. It comes back to a question of really getting the best nutrition in front of those animals that we can possibly put them in front of through our pastures. Meeting those nutritional needs then leads to, you know, better body condition scores for our breeder herd, better rebreed rates, better calving rates. That's our core metrics for production. So we've got a really strong connection between those two processes. We started working with SIBO Labs in 2018. We collected a lot of data across our landscape to inform that satellite tool. It's one source of data that helps us bring some precision and confidence in the data that we're using for making decisions. We're starting to look at how we can really leverage that data beyond forage budgeting, using it to understand our performance in managing our landscape effectively. So we set targets for residuals and pasture utilisation, so that's a tool for us to measure how effectively we're hitting those targets. We can use it to measure the response rate of pasture to rain, so how effective our pasture is, our production system is, how resilient that system is, and then make management decisions where we need to address issues that we see arising.
I think we learn a lot over time. And one of the things that you often see is if you can match your stocking rate to the carrying capacity for that year, you see animal performance really improve. And that's obviously through how you manage your pasture base. That's the first step. And it's really about having a structure within your herd where you can take animals off if you hit, say, drier type seasons. So that herd management profile is really important. But I think overall, I think it's probably just been more focused in on the pasture base, and particularly for us, we're in Northern Australia, so we've only really got one growing season, and that's our feed base for the year. And we need to be quite honed in on that as to how many animals we can run, and run productively is the key. I think the management procedures we changed are more constant forage budgeting is one. So really ensuring that we understand what feed base is on the ground right throughout the year, and not just a one snapshot part post wet season like perhaps we've traditionally done in the past. Looking at future weather patterns, what's the odds of, you know, the monsoon start, for example? How does that fit into where our feed base is at that time? And then within our herd, making sure that we've got that many. So for example, preg testing all of our females so we know that which are the animals we might need to turn off at whatever point in time. Positive outcomes have been in the past 3 to 4 seasons, which have been, you know, below average. We've actually seen an increase in our pasture base as a result of ensuring that we got stocking rate right, that we've made the right decisions around turn off when we've had to. Individual animal production as a whole, obviously you've got a stronger, more nutritious pasture base, so you've got the ability to express those genetics in things like fertility. So branding rates have gone up, conceptions within our heifers have gone up, calf loss has gone down. All of those fundamental traits to fertility have improved greatly.